And welcome back to more Pillars of Eternity. I'm the RPG Chick. We gotta head to Twin Elms. We are here at Cadnoa. Not sure if we can get there from Deerfoot Crossing. Or if I have to go to Stormwall Gorge. I see there's a road leading right up. I wouldn't be surprised if there's something else over here that we have to travel through first. Oh. I didn't mean to pause us, I wanted us to go faster. Okay, it's been a couple weeks since I've played this. We're taking our current party with us. Well, I see a road leading right this way, so let's go here. Rather than go out of our way. There might be more than one way there, I'm not sure, so. Now, I've been here before. We haven't figured this out, though. I wonder if maybe now we could. Oh, it's got sun on it now. All right, let's. What? Something going on over here. Oh, it's a deer. Well, it's using its cloak of invisibility. Kind of threw me off there. Okay, same description as usual. I can't. Alright. I don't have an option to do anything with it now. Or am I thinking of somewhere else? Was that open before?
Time to see and not be seen.
So I guess I'm having trouble remembering exactly. I don't think we've been down here. I don't think that was open. It opened. We were waiting for the sun to go on it, I guess. That's what we were waiting for, and now it's open. Kind of threw me out. We didn't have an option to do anything. What's that about? The Inguithan symbols are worn and faded, but the words strike a familiar chord. Duty before self. Okay, so that goes down, but we continue on this way as well. Stone head. You hear grating and grinding coming from the stone head above you. The chips of Adra in its eye sockets glow bright green. It is talking to us. A voice, deep and resonant, echoes from the stone mouth. What begins as a garble of language resolves itself into your own mother tongue. You've got a universal translator's on there. There is no truer blade than essence forged in bronze. Turn twice to the left and prepare your soul for its reckoning. Turn twice to the left. What are we turning? I hear something moving. Oh. A Widowmaker spider. Okay. Unless it means turn us and go here? I don't know what else we can turn. But... yeah, I don't know. Alright, we're kind of messed up here. Kind of still messed up. Alright. Let's attack the Widowmaker.
Yeah.
And friends. Okay, we didn't get to do much. Tough this enemy is. We already knocked down one. So I guess it's not that tough. We knocked down one dot or whatever the hell.
Following your lead.
Following my lead. Get up there.
Hey.
Kanna, seriously. You missed the action.
Alright. Yeah?
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very.
Sorry about that. Hit the mic a little. Interesting. I hear another thing moving. A peridot. Well, it wanted us to turn to the left. Or turn something to the left. So let's move to the left. Crystal Eater Spiderling? Wow.
Yes?
Yes.
That's it!
Ooh, one down. Awesome. Standard techniques here. There's only one more. Yeah. Spiders. No loot from these guys.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Constantly cautious. Still going to the left. I don't know if that's what it means, but a shade and a shade.
Following your lead.
Don't even...
Oh boy. Spectres. Get rid of these foul vermin. That one's almost dead. Once they get in formation, a little fire. Wonder if we'll hit that in time. To kill that and make it detonate. Oh, Kenna has knocked down now. This poor thing, like, is loading everything on it.
This isn't working!
I don't know if that did what we wanted it to. Okay, they're kind of like flowing all around us here. Let's see if Aeloth can throw some fun in here. Attached to him from all the way over there.
What?
Kanna's in rage mode. Alright, we got rid of that. I don't know if she's doing anything.
What?
Gather round. My, we need to rest. Or Aeloth. Yeah, you messed up.
Eh?
Hey. You rest right here. Your eyes open to a familiar scene. Durance sits with his staff laid across his lap, a malignant flame sprouting from one end. He is difficult to make out, his features soft, bleeding together. But the staff you can see clearly, its etchings aglow in molten orange. Though Durance's face is difficult to distinguish, there is no mistaking the hardened expression, the furrowed brow. His voice hisses and sputters, low and unintelligible, as though having a private argument with the staff. Traces of spittle catch the firelight as they fly from his lips like sparks. And to your surprise, there is a female figure behind him. You are about to call out a warning when you realizes the Magwin statue where you met Durance at the fork. Yet, she seemed almost alive for a moment. Her cast shadow seemed as if it was moving, cloaked, then it is still, frozen with a knight at its back. Examine the staff. There was something odd about one of the symbols, a circle of 12 smaller circles. One of the small circles glows brightly, but the other 11 give off little light. They flicker and fade like dying embers. Between his hissing curses, Durance lowers his face close to the staff and blows on the fading circles with panicked rapidity, coaxing light from them, but they do not ignite. One by one, the light of the circles dies, and smoke rises from their ashes. Only one still burns. Durance hurls the staff at his feet, and it clatters to the ground. Its edges have become soft, difficult to find. Like its owner, the staff has become a blur. You close your eyes and reopen them, and Durance is there, picking up his staff from the ground. But the blur is gone, and you are awake. What? Find out from Durance what the fading symbols mean. In the dream, Durance seemed to try to rekindle them, but it was no use. Durance will know what it meant, as he did with the last dream. Alright, Durance, out with it. Your face is full of need, Durance snorts. It looks to burst if you didn't speak. I had questions I wanted to ask you.
If doubts and curiosity plague you, you're skinning your knuckles on the wrong door.
I had another vision of you, one of the symbols on your staff. It was dying.
You see many things that aren't there, Watcher. Perhaps the symbol was for your disappearing sanity, and we are to bid it farewell while you still have the wits to grieve for it.
I saw a symbol with 12 circles. What does it represent?
That symbol? The Godhammer.
Durance frowns, and the words come slowly. Then it was the Godhammer symbol I saw extinguished on your staff.
No riddle there, Watcher. It took 12 of us to build the Godhammer. Afterward, I took my leave of all of them to see what Margaren had in store for me. I've seen none of them since.
Are you sure there isn't more to that story?
Your kind has a way of interpreting its visions to fit the version of the truth you like best. But Margaren's flame leaves no room for interpretation. Waste the time of others with your distortions and your fever dreams.
Okay, so we got experience even though he really didn't answer us. Huh. Interesting. Flames distort all that lies around them, and you never seem to be far from a flame.
It's always the way of the mad to try to convince others of a reality only they can see. But when your doctrine's the truth, it requires no convincing, only an opening of the eyes. I would purify you, Watcher, if I thought it would help.
I think he just told us he would set us on fire. I want to ask about something different.
The cost of troubling me seems to worry you little.
Have we asked him this? Tell me about Margaren. Gods, you are swelling with questions. One would think you were a child, or burning up inside. I guess I asked him all these.
I suspect the answers will seed more questions.
Let's check out number 4, region and its history. I don't remember asking about the salvation. I wanted to know more about the salvation. When the animancers tried to place animal souls into children, Durance snarls. If you ever needed proof of their trespasses, that alone speaks to it. Wide-Wind may have taken a god, but to put an animal inside the vessel of a child? Durance shakes his head, his face wrinkling in disgust. Animancy is madness. Worse, it took too long to see the crime for what it was. I heard of the first tales, the Orlin suffering first. He chuckles ruefully, then sneers, like they always do. Animals within animals, compounding the madness. Did you see what happened? First was a woman. Could have chalked that up to female weakness. Then the catmen. Could have chalked that up to them being animals. His hands tightened on the staff. Then more and more, and more souls ended up at their claws.
A weak woman carried you into this world from the wheel, Postanago.
Go, Palagina. Durance's face hardens. I would have given anything to place them within a cage with those they saved, and see their craft shape the craftsmen. Let those children tear their tormentors apart. I can only give a taste of what they should suffer. It is meager fare for us both. What is the Godhammer?
Gods have taken flesh, in all respects, taking willing and unwilling vessels. It's not a violation. It's what gods do, as long as they accept all that comes with it. Men are weak. Gods? Well, we showed old Widewen that he was flesh and blood, no matter how much light was pouring out of his farmer's hands. Took men of faith to build a weapon. A godhammer. Judgment. Proved him dead at Halgott's Citadel.
It was a weapon of Deerwood's people, their independence. There are few that would deny that Aethys oversnapped. The godhammer reminded Aethys of this. A fire and force so terrifying, so bright, it burned a god away. Durance holds his staff, and his hands lock around it, tracing the etchings. As you watch, the top of the staff blossoms, burns brightly, and Durance speaks, his face illuminated in the fire. A weapon that would burn brighter than Aethys, and we led him to it and burned him at the stake. The stake was the godhammer, and we impaled him on it. You said you fashioned it? Durance nods. Wasn't easy, shaping it, crafting it. The pieces, the curve of the relic. Even then, it was a massive thing. Something that required a god to come to it, rather than be cast at him. Though luring him to it, that was the easy part. Gods are prideful. What happened? We led him to fields, ones that he remembered as a farmer, perhaps. The fields right outside Halgott Citadel. Durance frowns. Now Godhammer Citadel. It was right after the Evan Dewar Bridge, an easy trek. He frowns. Men died, then more died, luring Aethys onto Evan Dewar. We had carved veins and passed through the bridge, excavated the foundations, filled them with powder and ember-hungry grains, eager to burn. Our hands had even pried the mortar and rock loose, sharpened them to points, so that they might be rent from their foundations easier, and tear through the flesh of that pretender. And so you used Evandura against Aethys.
We poured the godhammer into its foundations with faith. Set it alight. Let the hammer fall, upwards onto the anvil. 8 died before the godhammer fell. And the godhammer claimed the remainder. 12 in all.
And Aethys went back to the ether. Or the grave. He's lost his voice and his love of war, I'll tell you that much. He sneers. It took only taunts by men, and that was enough to lure him across the bridge and right into the new sun. He straightens his back, draws a deep breath. It let Red Saris see how bright their arrogance had become, and become a symbol by which we answered their purge with one of our own. Purges? Yeah, I might have asked this before, guys, so if I did, my apologies. It's been so long ago since I talked to him last, I can't even remember.
We started saving the Aethasians from themselves, burning any that didn't die with their god. Heresy in Raed Saris is one thing. Heresy here in the Deerwood comes with a more personal touch.
It might just be me, but the purges seems familiar, like we've asked him about this much before, but the Godhammer part seems new to me. Possibly I'm just not remembering that he spoke of this. I remember this these kind of judgmental answers. Why the purges?
As I see it, every Aothasian who still lives in the Deerwood puts the nation at risk. Is another dagger held to the throat of our faith. Root them out, burn them, or send them back to Raid Saras to wallow in the blood of their failure.
He's had enough. He's not going to answer anymore. So the fading circles on the staff. Did he say this? He claimed it represented his lost connection with the other engineers of the Godhammer, whom he left behind to follow his own path after the destruction of Aethas. When the time is right, I'll see if there isn't more to be learned about this. I guess he hinted around about that.
Time to see and not be seen.
I'll see what I can find.
Alright, let's continue into this chamber. Got one spider we haven't looted. Oh, there's something there. Oh, we can talk to it. Let's finish exploring the chamber first. Yeah, I was trying to figure out if it's behind that. I guess it is on top. No secrets. Okay, so I guess this is where we get judged. I don't want to get separated from the group too far. The stone faces Adra eyes glow, and a voice rumbles from its open mouth. The past is the hilt of a weapon. The true warrior grasps it and knows her strength. Speak the quality that defines you. Okay. Interesting. I don't know what this is leading to. Maybe if I say this, won't get isolated from our allies. I bring people together. I'm at my best when working alongside my allies. These are all good answers, by the way. So it is with your power. A symbol burns on the wall behind the stone head. Ooh. I thought you were being transported somewhere. Now what? The stone head is silent, its Adra eyes have dulled. What's this symbol? Oh, we can't examine the symbol or do anything. Interesting. So we've got other symbols that could have lit up. I have a feeling there's some kind of reckoning to be had once we go through there, and I'm gonna save that for next episode. I want to explore the rest of this chamber. Layer Rhemen. Or this dungeon, rather.
And what does the flame reveal?
More about our friend Durance, hopefully soon. I hear something moving around. Another Widowmaker. Might as well take these things out. Poor Canna, always so confused.
Yes?
He agrees. He's like, yes? Ooh, took that one out. Nice.
Get moved!
Who's attached to this? Palagina. soul ignition on this one.
Following your lead.
Oh, out already. I said just wait in.
Helpful?
Ooh. You feel an unwelcome crawling sensation in your head. A high-pitched ring overwhelms your senses as it accompanied by an angry utterance. Invader! Thief! The voice is alien and fierce, jolting through your mind like lightning. Are we hearing the spiders? Needles stab at your brain with every syllable, but vanish abruptly along with the words. The ringing in your head is gone. Did we hear the spiders?
Sure.
We continue that way, and of course...
I'll see what I can find.
There's this way. What is this? Oh, a hole! I don't want to be going in that just yet. A cylindrical hollow, scarcely wider than the shaft of a weapon, runs through the center of this pedestal. What's up here? Oh, there's more of those symbols. No secrets? Reveal your secrets. The serpentine symbols and icons of Ingwith engraved into the floor resolve into words in your mind. The warrior shall call forth two witnesses, and they shall take up positions upon the emblems that bear testament to the character of his soul. The warrior shall ascend the dais, soul vessel in hand, to undergo transference. Bearing his soul vessel and a weapon with the heart of Adra, the warrior may then approach the urn. In this way, he shall fashion an arm worthy of his skills and ambitions. Huh. Two witnesses. His soul vessel and a weapon with the heart of Adra. Huh. Do we get a new arm or something? We don't have that kind of a weapon. Maybe we can come back with one. And that's... going down. I'm gonna peek at that next episode. I'm gonna save the game, start off the next episode. We'll peek in that, and I mean, I don't want to go down in there. At least not yet. But I do want to peek in the hole. See what there is to be done with the friggin' hole. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.